How about Shemel Shah? Barakatah Yahawa Shah. Barakatah Yahawa. Barakatah Yahawa. Barakatah Yahawa Shah.
Nor come to pass.
We in June. Ain't no microchips. We in June. Ain't no microchips.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 18 and verse 22. When a prophet speaketh in the name of the Lord Yahweh by Shemel Shai, if the thing follow not nor come to pass, that is the thing which the Lord hath not spoken, but the prophet hath spoken it presumptuously, thou shalt not be afraid of him. Barakatah Yahweh, Barakatah Yahweh Shai, Kahala Yahweh by Shemel Shai, by Shemel HaKadash. And double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone that taught me this truth, and much respect to the Akimat that labored in his work, and also to the believers scattered across the four corners of the earth, the whole elect at USA. Shalom. So yeah, there's gonna be a stern warning for you Israelites who continue to watch and subscribe to these other camps such as IUYC, ISUBK, HOY, WFI, who did not teach about Revelation 13 and 16 being an actual mark, meaning the chip, as you saw in the opening. And this is pretty much going out to you blind believers who follow, you know, these other camps in your ignorance. All right, you follow these camps in your ignorance, meaning that you may be sincere about seeking the truth, but you are just following the wrong people. And so what the Lord is doing is he's making known who he's dealing with, right, by making the words manifest that are spoken, all right, speaking about the prophecies. So again, Deuteronomy 18 and 22, when a prophet speaketh in the name of the Lord Yahweh by Shemel Shai, if the thing follow not nor come to pass. Now, Great Millstone from 2007, dealing with the apostles, starting from Apostle DeHaan down, spoke about the chip. They also spoke about martial law and all hell breaking loose, the famines, concentration camps and all of that, and they were laughed to scorn, they were mocked and ridiculed. And all of a sudden in 2021 going into 22, all this stuff has been made manifest right before your eyes. So this just shows you, just off the scripture, who the Lord is dealing with. All right, so it ain't no microchip. It's June anymore. It is a microchip in 2021 heading into 2022, man. You see? So the Lord is making known his words unto you. All right? So again, a warning. If you're following these different camps, the Lord is going to destroy you because he's not dealing with them. All right? You're following a camp who's calling on Christ. In a time like this, you're about to head into all hell. Extreme hell is about to break loose, man. And you're going to be calling on Jesus Christ or Christ in that day. No, the Lord is not going to answer to another God, man. That's another name given to another God. All right, we deal with a jealous power here. So anyway, let's go to the book of Proverbs real quick. Proverbs 4 and 18, but the path of the just is as shining light that shineth more and more into the perfect day. So what does that mean? The path is talking about this truth that the just are following. And it is as a shining light that shineth more and more until the perfect day, that perfect day being the return of our Lord Yahweh Shai. So the more prophecies that come to pass, it makes this light or this truth shine more. So now it's like it cannot be hidden. It's out there now, all right? When you go to the book of Habakkuk, the second chapter and verse 3, it says, for the vision. All right, so what is the vision? Let's get it real quick. For the vision in Hebrew 2:3-7:7. All right, definition C, vision, oracle, prophecy, divine communication. So Revelation 19 and 10 tells us that the spirit of Yahweh Shai is the spirit of prophecy. So this is what your ministry should be focused on, the upcoming events leading to the destruction of America and the establishing of the kingdom of heaven. All right. So they're not preaching about what's to come, you know, dealing with prophecy, then they don't have any vision. The Lord's not dealing with them. Vision as title of book of prophecy. All right. Get down here. You got a revelation or oracle. So going back, Habakkuk 2 and 3, for the vision or the prophecy is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak. And we're in the end and it's speaking. It says, and not lie. So the apostle spoke about the chip back in 07, and now it's here. So has that been a lie? No. It said, though it tarry, a wait for it. So they had to wait. We all had to wait, okay, as a body, because it will surely come, it will not tarry, and it has come. So this scripture is living out right before your eyes, man. All right, it's playing out right before your eyes. And so you got to ask your congregation or your teacher, your pastor, you know, what the hell is going on? I thought you said that it wasn't going to be a chip. Ain't no microchip, you know. So they have been found out to be liars already. Isaiah 9 and 16, for the leaders of this people cause them to error, and they that are led of them are destroyed. You see? So if you follow in that false leader, he's going to lead you to destruction. For one, he did not teach you about the significance of the damn kerygma, the chip. All right. What should I say? For one, he did not teach you the name of the Heavenly Father and the Son, Yahweh and Yahweh Shai. And secondly, he did not teach you about the kerygma, Revelation 13 and 16, the chip. Okay. And the significance of it, because it's going to be a point in time in which resources are going to be gone. All right. You're going to have two options. Either go to Esau and take the chip and receive your benefits, or you're going to depend on Yahweh by Shemel Shai through faith, and he's going to provide for you. And the consequence for taking that thing or that chip is going to be destruction. You see? So during this period of time, your leaders are supposed to be warning you and preparing you and building you up in the faith through the names of Yahweh by Shemel Shai to prepare for these moments that are coming, which is called Jacob's trouble, in order for you to endure. So your pastors and your teachers have not comforted you concerning prophecy. And so it's going to hit you like a ton of bricks, you see, and you're going to crumble unless you repent and turn back into Yahweh by Shemel Shai. So it says, and they that are led of them are destroyed, following Nate, following Zabak, you know, following all these different camps that are not prepping you up, where you're going to be led into your destruction. All right. And a lot of you Israelites just think, because you understand that you're an Israelite, that you're going to be good. Well, let's see what the scripture say about that. All right, let's go to Matthew 3 and verse 9. It says, and think not to say within yourselves, we have Abraham to our father. What does that mean? Don't say within yourself, I'm of the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I'm an Israelite, so I'm good. No. It says, for I say unto you that the Most High is able of these stones to raise up children unto Abraham. You see? Let's read it to the right in NLT. Don't just say to each other, hey, we're safe. Hey, I'm an Israelite, I'm good, I ain't got shit to worry about. Nate said, I ain't gonna be no Jacob's trouble. Hey, it ain't gonna be no Mark. All we gotta do is wait on the Lord to show up just out of the blue. There's not gonna be any kind of trouble. We say we good, we Israelites. It says, for we are descendants of Abraham. Let's read it from the top again. Don't just say to each other, we're saved. For we are descendants of Abraham. That means nothing, man. The Lord don't care that you understand you're an Israelite. Matter of fact, the Lord rolls up a lot of Israelites to understand that the Israelite just so he can destroy them. There's a thing called reincarnation, and this is the time of the Lord's vengeance. And he has raised up Israelites and woke them up to the fact that they are Israelites just so they can be destroyed. Because it all comes down to obedience at the end of the day. All right. You obeying what the Lord sent out for you to believe in. We're just talking about the doctrine. Okay. It says, I tell you, the Most High can create children of Abraham from these very stones. Back in the KJV to the left, verse 10. And now also the axe, which is Yahweh Shai, is laid unto the root of the trees. The root of the trees is talking about you Israelites. he's going to cut you off. Therefore, every tree which bringing not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. So if you're not teaching by the MOTB, if you're not teaching in the names of Yahweh by Shemel Shai, all right? If you're not teaching about Jacob's trouble, then the Lord eventually is going to cut you down. And you're gonna, and he's going to cast you into the fire. And that fire is talking about thermonuclear fire in these times. Like I just said, reincarnation is all throughout the scriptures. And people have been raised up just to be destroyed, man. So just think not to yourself, you know, that you're an Israelite. You know, we got Abraham to our father. Because the Lord don't give a damn about that. He requires obedience. You see? So, man, hey, if I were you, I would repent and turn back into Yahweh by Shemel Shai and humble yourself and accept the doctrine that you Israelites have denied and talked about for so long. All right. Matter of fact, let's go to Romans, the 10th chapter real quick. What did the Lord say? Romans 10:21. But to Israel, he said, all day long have I stretched forth my hands. All right. His hand is talking about his prophets, unto a disobedient and gainsaying people. So Lord has his prophets stretched out, telling you the truth, rebuking, you know, through love. And but people don't want to receive it. They rather follow after the lust of their own flesh and follow after what they like, fulfilling their own belly. You see, which is their mind. So you're going to gravitate to what you like instead of hearing the truth and accepting it. You see. So let's get this word disobedient in the Greek 5:4:4. It says not to allow oneself to be persuaded to refuse or withhold belief. So you got people out there who understand that the mark may be the chip, but due to them not liking great millstone, they're going to refuse it anyway. All right. To refuse belief or obedience. All right. And obedience to not comply with. Okay. Willfully. Strong's definition. To disbelieve willfully and perversely. You got a lot of Israelites who understand that we teach truth, but due to their flesh, they can't submit to it. All right. So what is going to happen to them? They're going to be destroyed unless they repent. You see? So for now, let's go to the book of Jeremiah, 14th chapter. And we'll go to the verse, Jeremiah 14 and verse 13. It says, then said I, Lord Yahweh by Shemel Shai, behold, the prophets say unto them, and ye shall not see sword, and neither shall ye have famine, but I will give you a sure peace in his land. And this is a telltale sign of a false prophet. Someone is telling you that it's going to be sweet. You're not going to have any trouble. All right. Go on about your business. You got to worry about nothing. You got to worry about no famine. You got to worry about no race wars, no martial law troops, Esau coming down with wrath. You know, you ain't got to worry about none of that. Just live your life, man, and wait on the Lord. All right. And so this is what Nate has been telling this congregation. All right. There is no Jacob's trouble. All right. Then he kind of reneged on a little bit. But he prepped this congregation to be in a jolly type spirit. And so they're going to be caught off guard along these other camps as well, man. All right, Sakari, ISHBK, nigga said Jacob's trouble is gay. I think the Lord going to make that man eat his words. All right, he's going to find out how gay Jacob's trouble is. You know, if you get what I'm saying. You know how the Lord pays people back according to that word. So, that's a cold statement that dude made. Anyway, Jeremiah 14 and verse 14. Then said the Lord Yahweh by Shemel Shai. All right. It's like at the end, the Lord Yahweh said unto me, the prophets prophesied lies in my name. I sent them not, and neither have I commanded them, neither spake unto them. They prophesied unto you a false vision and divination. All right. Well, this guy, Ayathan from IUIC, talking about the chip is divination. But you see the chip right now. So who is really teaching divination? And a thing of not, and the deceit of their heart, right? The deceit of their mind. Therefore said the Lord, son of the prophets, they prophesy in my name, and I sent them not. Yet they say, sword and famine should not be in this land. By sword and famine shall those prophets be consumed. And get this, and the people to whom they prophesy shall be cast out in the streets of Jerusalem. This is going to happen again. He said, because of the famine and the sword, and they shall have none to bury them, their wives, nor their sons, nor their daughters. Your family is going to be killed, man. All right, for listening to these niggas. For I will pour their wickedness upon them. You see? So Lord is not playing. 70 AD is going to happen all over again. And, you know, this is the vengeance of Yahweh by Shemal Shah. And he's going to lead a lot of Israelites to destruction because he simply don't want them. He set up false leaders for you to follow just so you can be destroyed along with them. All right? But there are going to be some sincere believers that come out of that madness and repent and be a part of the elect. All right? So yeah, what you should be doing right now, if you are sincere, is repenting. All right? As the script says, repent and believe the gospel. I think that's Acts 3:19. I know it's another one. Yeah, Mark 1:15. It says, and saying, the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of the Most High is at hand. And repent ye and believe the gospel. And there's only one gospel, you see? There's only one gospel. Acts 3:19. Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out. So you got to repent and believe the gospel, that your sins may be blotted out when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. Okay, because everything's going to be made new. We're going to get new bodies and all that. But you got to repent first. It says, and he shall send Yahweh Shah HaMashiach, which before was preached unto you. You see? So repentance is literally you taking heed and following the doctrine that he set up, and not these other false leaders. Okay? And the true men that the Lord are dealing with are the men of Great Millstone and the like brothers who are teaching the same doctrine. So yeah, I just want to go through that real quick. You know, Lord willing, it was edifying. Till next time, I say shalom.